What do you make of the latest with regards to the hearing on Monday? Should the hearing proceed?
Well, you know, look, I have said all along that we should hit a pause button and let's just do a reset. This is getting a little bit out of hand politically. I think we need to have more respect for Dr. Ford and the process that she's going through, all of the threats and everything that she's going through now. I think we need to pause this. Let the FBI do this investigation. The fact that I keep hearing that the FBI doesn't do this is simply not the case.
Well, clear that up for us, because Republicans that I talk to say that this is Department of Justice domain. Other folks say the FBI has a role here. Your take?
Look, the FBI does background checks every day. They do it for judges. They do it for U.S. attorneys. I have had FBI agents brief me on nominees that are coming before, and all the president has to do is just ask, and they will certainly do it. This nominee needs to have a full and fair hearing. Dr. Ford needs to have a full and fair hearing. But to do that, you have to do an investigation and get as many facts as you possibly can in order to give everybody the opportunity for the right question.
So it sounds like, Senator, you're saying don't have the hearing until the conclusion of the FBI investigation.
Well, I've said that all along, but that could happen before Monday. I don't know. I think the FBI moves very efficiently. But we've lost 4 or 5 days now that could have been gained. We have this artificial clock that has been set by the Republicans on the Judiciary Committee. There's nothing magic about getting this nomination rushed to judgment the way it's been done thus far.
With regards to specifically how Democrats on the committee have handled this, in particular, Senator Dianne Feinstein, top Democrat on the Judiciary Committee, are you satisfied with how she handled this allegation?
It doesn't really matter whether I'm satisfied or not at this point. No, the point is this. This process has been a failed process from the very beginning. Senator Grassley asked for documents back in July that he said were important for the committee's consideration. Those documents have not fully been produced yet and can't be produced until October. But yet we insist on having a hearing right after Labor Day. We insist on rushing. This is an artificial clock that has been set by the Judiciary Committee. So we are in a position now where we are, and it doesn't really matter what's happened in the past. We've got to deal with what's in front of us right now. And to do that, we need to hit a pause button. I've said it before. We need to hit a pause button and let the investigation play out. Let the FBI come in, do what they can to see if they can get any corroboration on this. If they can't, we move forward. But let's do that.
Respectfully, one more follow-up on this particular point, because the critics, obviously Republicans, are saying, well, hey, wait a minute. She got this allegation.
It's a red herring. She
got this allegation in the summer and met privately with Judge Kavanaugh. My question is, obviously, there could have been more time. So my question is, respectfully,
there can be more time now.
What is your reaction, though, to how she handled
it? It doesn't matter what my reaction is. It doesn't matter how. We are in a moment right now, and that's the only thing that's important. What has happened right now, you got to remember, Dr. Ford did not want to become her name publicly identified. It had to be as of Sunday, this past Sunday, for whatever reason. And so we've got to deal with the hand we're dealt now. And it is complete disrespect for her to try to blame this on a Democratic senator. Let's go with what we've got.
There's another massive story moving in Washington this week. That, of course, is trade. The president announcing $200 billion worth of tariffs against China. Right. China responding with $67 billion in tariffs of their own. I know you have concerns about reaction in the agricultural, particularly with soybeans, as well as the auto sector.
Yes, absolutely. There seems to be no real strategy. You know, every time we're going about this in a game of chicken, there doesn't seem to be an end game. We hear that there are talks going on, but we hear that there are talks not going anywhere.
And no talk schedules.
No schedules, nothing about this. I am concerned that farmers are going to be losing markets the longer this drags on. China has a strong economy. They can withstand this. They are withstanding it, and they're meeting force with force. We need to have a better strategy about it. We all know what the end game is. China has been a rogue nation with their products, with our technology. We need to have our allies and coordinate a strategy so that we can do this in a methodical way. This is going to hurt automobile manufacturers in my state and other states.
Other economists say the U.S. has the upper hand, but what say you?
Well, I don't see it. I mean, if we've got the upper hand, we need to start doing something and need to get some results immediately, because if we have the upper hand now, we're going to lose it rapidly, because China's putting money all over the world.